Whether you're just learning how to code, you're studying computer science, or you're a well-seasoned Mac developer, I have three apps that'll help make your life easier. And all of these are themselves open source. The first is an app by Paul Hudson, and it's called Control Room. This turbocharges the Xcode simulator. It's always good practice to test your app in a variety of different conditions, and Control Room lets you simulate bad or unreliable Wi-Fi coverage, weird geographic locations, suddenly revoked app permissions, and more. With one button click, you can trigger iCloud syncing and copy stuff to and from the clipboard between your Mac and the simulator. And it's really easy to make both screen recordings and GIFs. Next up is an app called Cork, and this gives you a super easy to use interface for Homebrew. Homebrew is of course a really popular package manager, but sometimes it can be really hard to remember the terminal commands. Well, with Cork, you can see everything you have installed in this little sidebar here on the left. If you click on one, you can see what dependencies it has with other packages you have installed. You have one button right here where you can pin it to a specific version to prevent it from updating. And you can start an update just by clicking this refresh button in the toolbar. If you want to add a new package, you just click this plus here. And what's really great about it is that it's actually a search field. You don't need to type in the exact name. So if I just type in FFmpeg, I don't even know what I'm looking for here. I'll see a full list that I can install with one click. I encourage you to buy the app and support the developer if you can afford to do so, but you can also build it yourself from the GitHub. Last but not least is an app called Xcodes. This makes installing updates and managing versions of Xcode super easy. So maybe you're developing an app for the next major version of iOS, but you also need to use the old version of Xcode to support your existing apps on the App Store. Xcodes makes it super simple. You can browse all the versions and filter between pre-releases and final releases, install them with just one click. You can change which version is the active version. But the real kicker is in the settings page. Go to the Experiments tab and check this box that says Faster Unzip. This uses a special algorithm that takes full advantage of Swift concurrency. It'll light up all the cores on your Mac, so you can get up to 70% faster unzips. It's super helpful. You can get notifications when new versions are available and have them install fully automatically. I highly recommend it. Links to all of these projects, along with an article version of this video, are in the description. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.